Hi there, Titans. Welcome to Titan Academy, another video where we are discussing Titan flows. We are going to be learning about how to add conditions to our flows. Now, to do this, you'll start on any node that you want this condition to stem from, and then you can go to add, click on condition, and this is where we can set up our rules. So here we can select a field, we'll go to settings, and we can say what type of field, whether it's a project, that means that it is coming from the project that this flow is stemming from, a parameter that lives on the parameter, or true or false. So I'm going to choose project. I'm gonna select the project, which right now I only have one project assigned to this flow, and then I can assign a field. So maybe I will say if the email address, if the email is not empty, all right, and instead of adding our the then here, what we do instead is we can see that the node appears, and then we can assign the actions to take place for the outcomes of this condition. So rule one was what I just assigned, so we can edit this tag to be if email is not empty, perfect, and then else will be like if it is empty. So if it is not empty, then I'm going to send an email. Just delete this. I'm going to create a new email. The recipient can be from the project, Titan Flows. And I'm going to choose the email field. I'm going to send it via Titan. And just call it from Titan. And the content, I'm going to say hi, and we can use a project field to include their first name, space, project field, which is the project, and then the field within that last name. All right, so I gave them a little message. Perfect. Make sure you select the email. So if the email field is not empty, then we will send an email to that user. And if not, then we will send an email to create a new template. I'll say missing email, and the recipient will be, I'm gonna make it static and just make it to myself. Cool, sent to from Titan, and then the content, I will say hi, and I can include my name. I'll just say, hi, this contact was unable to, this contact was attempted to be created, but did not have an email filled. Okay, and then I can do first name, and I'll include that first name that was from the project. Last name, apply. Awesome. All right. And again, make sure that you select what email template is on each rule. So I'm going to name these nodes. Rule one, send welcome email to user. Send error email to page. All right, so these are the two conditions. So my flow will go, the user will fill out this form, and if this field is empty, then it will send an error to myself. If it is not empty, then it will send a welcome email to the user. All right, so I'm going to save and then publish this. And we can see that in this, let's go to our other project, Titan Flows 1. Here, when the user clicks this button, it triggers the workflow. All right, so I'm going to save and preview this, and we're going to watch this flow take place. So let's say Gary Bills, and then let's leave the email blank. And here we can see the email has come through. User is missing email. Hi, this contact was attempted to be created but did not have an email filled. So we can have their first and last name. And then when the user types in, let's give them my email address so they can watch this come through. So Gary Bills, when Gary creates his contact, he will receive that confirmation email now because the email was filled. And let's watch it. Here it is. Welcome. Hi, Gary Billsby. Your contact has been successfully submitted. Thank you. All right. So that is how you set up conditions. And of course, you can have any actions take place on your conditions. And you can have conditions on any dynamic or static element in your forms or Salesforce environments. So hope this video helped. And thank you for watching.